Have you ever asked yourself, a single family dwelling, a condo, an apartment building, a duplex, a mobile home, which one will bring the most profit? In this video, you will get the top 5 most profitable property types, as well as important information every real estate investor should know. Stick around to the end of the video as I share my favorite hack to get the most out of any of these property types. Hey, what's up? It's Darren Voros. My mission is to help 1,000 people create over $1 million in net worth with real estate investing. Subscribe not to miss what's coming. Before we jump in, it's important to understand how we can measure profit on a real estate investment. There are many different metrics that we could use, but for this video, I want to use 4 profit metrics that you should look for in all real estate investments. Let's start with the one that gets people most excited about real estate, and that is market appreciation. This is the value increase on the property. So if you were to purchase a property for $400,000 and you sell it for $500,000, the market appreciation would be $100,000. The second metric we can use is cash flow. Cash flow is pretty simple. We take our monthly revenue and we subtract our expenses. If there's money left over, that is our cash flow. The third metric we can use is mortgage paydown. Mortgage payments are broken down into 2 categories, principal and interest. Interest is the cost to service the loan. But each time you pay down the principal, you're building equity. So you have to account for that in your profit. The last metric is one of my favorites, and that is forced appreciation or active appreciation. The number one way to achieve forced appreciation is, you guessed it, through renovation or improving the property. By improving the property, we can often spend less on the actual improvements than the value increase that we can create. So now that we know the 4 ways we can make money on a property, let's break down the 5 most profitable property types using our 4 metrics. Number 5, the condo. The reason why condos are not higher on my list is because of 2 dirty little words: maintenance fees. Maintenance fees are charged every single month, regardless of whether you own the property outright or you have a mortgage on it. Maintenance fees can be raised with little to no notice, and if the fees collected don't cover all of the required maintenance on a condo, the condo board can force a cash call with the owners. Maintenance fees can eat into your cash flow significantly. For this reason, condos can often only have 2 ways to generate profit: mortgage paydown and equity appreciation. The good thing about condos is that they generally require less maintenance, and you as the condo owner are only responsible for maintaining your unit. So this can be a very hands-off investment at times. The 4th most profitable property type is a single family dwelling. I like single family dwellings for a couple of reasons. If you're buying a single family dwelling in a good neighborhood, there should always be demand as a rental. The other positive to owning single family dwellings as rental properties is they are relatively easy to liquidate if and when you want to sell. The downside to a single family dwelling is that you have a single revenue. So if you don't have a tenant, your property is not generating any income. I also see fewer and fewer markets across Canada where single family dwellings generate significant cash flow to cover all of your expenses because of the high purchase price. If you're unsure of how to calculate cash flow, check out this video where I explain the 4 categories most investors don't include when calculating cash flow after you've finished this video. In the US, it's a bit of a different story, as you can still buy properties for $50,000 in some markets that will generate $700 to $800 in monthly rent. This can be a great investment when you consider the property will cash flow, the mortgage will get paid down, and ideally, the property will appreciate in value. Number 3, a multifamily dwelling. A multifamily dwelling would be defined as a duplex, triplex, fourplex, and sometimes a 5-unit building. Anything over 5 units is generally considered an apartment building, which is a different category. The reason I like multifamily dwellings is that in most cases, you have a single building envelope, roof, heating system, yard, driveway, and structure to maintain, but you have multiple revenues to support all the costs associated with that property. It's also great for vacancies. If you have 4 units and 1 is sitting vacant, you still have 3 additional revenues to cover all of your expenses. Multifamily dwellings generally have higher cash flow, will still get mortgage pay down, and you should see similar growth in equity appreciation to a single family dwelling if your multifamily dwelling is situated in a good residential neighborhood. The 2nd most profitable property type is an apartment building. It's a simple numbers game that the more units you have, the lower your cost per unit will become. For instance, if you buy a fourplex for $400,000, your cost per unit would be $100,000 per unit. In a similar market, you may be able to get a 10-unit building for $800,000. So your cost per unit now drops to $80,000 per unit. In most cases, the rent that you can collect on a two-bedroom unit in a fourplex and a two-bedroom unit in a 10-unit building will be very similar, but your cost to acquire that building will be less. Apartment buildings are also evaluated differently than a single-family dwelling or a multifamily dwelling. The value of the building is based on the net operating income using a cap rate versus single-family dwellings, which are evaluated based on comparable properties in the neighborhood. So if you can increase your revenue and decrease your expenses, you can impact the value of that apartment building. You also have the added benefit of a multifamily building in that you can generally have one structure and one roof to maintain, but 10 revenues to offset those costs. And if you have 10 units and one unit is vacant, you have 9 other revenues still coming in. And the number one most profitable property type is not really a property type per se, but more of a strategy. The most profitable property type by far is generally a property that is being developed. In other words, taking raw land and creating housing on that land. In some cases, we do this through what's called land assembly, where we take 2 or 3 individual properties, we buy them all, we combine the lots together, and then build a multifamily property on that land. The other option is to literally buy raw land and then create housing. To give you an idea of how this works, we just purchased a piece of land in Barrie, Ontario for $3 million that had 2 single properties on 2 large lots. With a zoning change, we will create 44 condos on that same piece of property. So when you look at your cost per unit, our cost to build and the sale price of these units, there can be significant profit in a transaction like this. Think of it like this. A t-shirt manufacturer doesn't just start selling t-shirts. They buy the fabric in bulk. Then they hire someone to make the t-shirts. Then they sell the t-shirts for a profit. They buy it wholesale and sell it retail. We do the same thing in real estate. We buy the land in bulk, hire someone to construct the building, and then sell the units or rent them out at retail value. It's business 101. It's not all sunshine and roses though. The downside to land development is that it can take a long time and it can cost a lot of money. Now, this may seem daunting to many of you and I wouldn't suggest it for your very first transaction, but it may be something you want to eventually work towards as you can see massive profits if you can execute on these kinds of strategies. Now, my favorite hack to make any of these strategies more profitable is finding creative ways to increase your cash flow and add value to your properties through renovation. Mortgage paydown will be consistent, and if you use a conservative 3% equity appreciation rate, that will be consistent as well across your properties. The factor that can significantly impact how profitable you are is how much cash flow you can make and how much you can increase the value of the building by renovating it. By getting creative with strategies like house hacking, short-term Airbnbs, and co-living to increase cash flow, and combining that with renovation strategies like burring, conversions, and development, you can significantly increase your profits. For more information on those various types of strategies and how they all work, you can register for one of my upcoming trainings that will begin in the fall of 2021. Check out my website at darrenvoros.com for more information. If you have any questions related to profitable property types or any other real estate investing questions, feel free to drop those in the comments section below. You can also follow me on Facebook and Instagram where I post additional real estate investing tips and techniques on a regular basis. And check back here every Tuesday as I release a new video every week. Thanks for watching and I'll see you soon.